all organisms, listed species, managed species, everything that we try and manage for the benefit of the American population needs habitat, needs a viable, strong habitat. And so what we try to do is to go into areas that have been impacted in some different way and to bring that habitat back to what it used to be. So we go into rivers, we remove dams to get the migrating fish back from the ocean to their spawning grounds. We go into wetlands that have been filled, that have been degraded in some fashion, we get the habitat back the way it used to be. And these are all important areas for nursing grounds or spawning grounds to help rebuild the population that then feeds back into the ocean. Many of these species, especially here in the northeastern United States, that use the rivers and the wetlands are forage, what we call forage fish. They are those fish that will feed the fish that we manage, the cod, the haddock, the sharks, the tuna, the billfish, those kinds of species rely upon the kinds of organisms that inhabit our wetlands. In the northeastern United States, which was the cradle of the Industrial Revolution, there are literally thousands of dams that are obstructing fish passage in our rivers. Many, many of those dams no longer serve a useful purpose. The mills have long gone, burned down, are no longer operating, yet the dams are still there, and they're still blocking passage in the rivers. And so that has had a tremendous impact on the population of anadromous fish. That is those fish that migrate from the oceans into the rivers and then spawn, and then the young migrate back out again into the ocean to live most of their life cycle. We go in those instances where dams can be removed, we usually work with the local communities, work with other organizations to remove the dam. The Edwards Dam was really the first large-scale dam removal in New England that took place over 10 years ago. And we've seen that population escalate to a couple million fish that are now running up the Sebastopol River. So there we've seen the population escalate tremendously in just a few short years. At any given time, we probably have 20 to 30 different projects that are ongoing. We have several large-scale dam removals that are planned, the most significant of which is on the Penobscot River in Maine. And there, in that case, we're targeting the recovery of Atlantic salmon, short-nosed sturgeon, Atlantic sturgeon, and a variety of other species, including river herring, which are also species of concern. In addition to fish passage, we're also involved in restoring salt marshes, tidal wetlands throughout the region. One of the larger scale projects that we completed recently is in Jersey City, New Jersey. This is a project called Lincoln Park, very urbanized area. It was a wetland that was filled back in the 40s to expand the park. The park was never completed, yet that filled wetland remained. We were able to work with the Hudson County to come in and remove fill and redesign the site. And now it's serving as a spawning area and a nursery ground for summer flounder and a variety of other organisms that serve as forage for our commercially and recreationally important fish.